Hello and welcome back to Learn Linux TV, and also welcome back to my Linux Crash Course series. In this video, we're going to take a look at the Zypper command. Zypper is a package manager, not unlike apt or other package managers for other distributions. This one in particular is actually specific to suse, suse itself as well as opensuse. So what we're going to do in this video is take a look at the Zypper command, and I'm going to give you some examples of the Zypper command in action. Now, before we get into that though, I do need to thank the sponsor for this video, which is Linode. Linode is a cloud provider, but not just any cloud provider. They're a Linux-focused cloud provider. On their platform, you can spin up your own Linux server in minutes, and they have all the distributions out there that you might want to learn, which includes, but isn't limited to, Ubuntu, Debian, CentOS, Rocky Linux. There's actually quite a few distributions on their platform that you could choose between, which makes Linode an especially great fit for Learn Linux TV. Their platform is a great way to get started and get your own server. Now, if you don't already have an account on Linode's platform, you can set one up quite easily by simply using the URL that you see on the screen right now, which will do two things. One, it'll get you $60 in free credit towards your new account, and that credit is good for up to 60 days. But in addition to that, it also lets Linode know that you heard about them through this channel, which actually supports the channel, and I would really appreciate that. And their platform is really awesome, not just for spinning up test servers, although, yeah, it's a great solution for that. You can set up your own website, a blog, a Minecraft server, a Nextcloud server. There's all kinds of things that you could use Linode's platform for, and on my end, it's actually the official cloud provider for Learn Linux TV, because every web-facing service for this channel is actually using Linode. Thank you so much to Linode for sponsoring this video, as well as the majority of this entire series. I really appreciate it. Anyway, I'm excited to show you some examples of the Zypper command in action, so let's get right into it. All right, so here I am on an OpenSUSE system. I figured I would install OpenSUSE because, well, Zypper is the official package manager for OpenSUSE, and that's also true for the enterprise version of SUSE as well. So here on this OpenSUSE system, what I'm going to do right now is show you the Zypper command, so let's get right into it. I mentioned earlier in the video that Zypper is a package manager, so what I'm going to do is give you some examples of package management with Zypper. So the first example that I'll give you then is how you go about searching for packages with the Zypper command. So what I'll do is type Zypper, and then I'll type search, because I want to search for something. Makes sense to me anyway. And let's say I want to install, I don't know, this is a desktop Linux distribution here, so how about I go about installing Thunderbird? So what I'll do is type Thunderbird as a search term. And the reason why we are searching for Thunderbird with the Zypper command is because we really don't know what the package name is going to be. I mean, it could be Thunderbird, spelled like you're seeing it right here, but it could be something else entirely. So by searching for a package, we could find out the exact name of the package that we want to install. As long as something in the metadata includes Thunderbird in this case, then it should show something in the search results, and maybe that'll point us to the right direction when it comes to which package we might want to install. So I'll press Enter, and let's see what it comes back with. So according to this, the package name is going to be Mozilla Thunderbird. The M and the T are capital in this case, so let's go ahead and use Zypper to install Thunderbird. At this point, if I go to my application launcher here and then Internet, you can see that Thunderbird is definitely not installed. It's not listed here where it's supposed to be listed, and if it was installed, it would have told us that it was installed in the output. But anyway, let's go ahead and install Thunderbird. So what I'll do is type sudo. I need root privileges in order to manage the packages on the system. You won't need sudo to search for packages, but you will need it when it comes to installing packages and also updating and removing packages as well. So I'll type Zypper yet again, and then install. And the package name was Mozilla with a capital M, and then Thunderbird with a capital T. So I'll press Enter, and we can see what the process looks like for installing a package with the Zypper command. Let's do it. So I'll type in my root password in this case. And in the case of Thunderbird, it's going to result in two packages being installed. libotr5 is actually a library, a dependency, Just like many of the package managers out there, Zypper is going to satisfy dependencies for you. So if the package that you intend on installing requires another package as a dependency in order for it to function, then Zypper is going to take care of that for you. And that may not seem like a big deal, but when I started, believe me, it was a big deal. Because back then, most package managers would only install the package that you gave it as an argument, no more, no less, which means dependency resolution was up to you. But thankfully for us, Zypper is going to take care of that for us. So I'll press Y for yes to confirm, and then I'll press Enter. Here, it shows that it actually installed Thunderbird, but is it really installed? Let's find out. And actually, here it is right here. So I'll click on it just to make sure that it opens. And there it is. There's Thunderbird. It's asking me to set up my email account. I'm not going to go as far as to do that in this video, but this actually proves that Thunderbird is working. So we were able to install it via Zypper. Anyway, for now, I'll just close out of Thunderbird, and then we'll continue with the tutorial. Now, when it comes to removing packages with the Zypper command, you could probably guess when it comes to the syntax for doing so, but I'll show you right now and we'll see if you're right. I'll use Thunderbird as an example again. So what I'll do is remove Thunderbird. Again, Thunderbird is installed. You can see it right there in the application launcher. So after I remove it, then it should disappear from the list. So to remove a package, in this case, Thunderbird, what I'll do is type sudo and then Zypper. Last time we used install as an argument here, but what I'm going to do is type remove. We want to remove a package. In this case, the package name was Mozilla Thunderbird, just like that. So I'll press Enter. And it's telling me that there's one package to remove. So I'll type Y for yes, and then I'll press Enter. And that's it. Thunderbird should now be removed. And as you can see here, Thunderbird is no longer present in this section of the application launcher. The package was removed. Now for the next example, I made my terminal window full screen. There's going to be quite a bit more information that's going to be displayed when we go through these examples. So I wanted to make sure you guys are able to see the output on the terminal without the text wrapping as much. It still might, but you know, not as much. Anyway, what I'm going to do right now is show you the process of installing updates with the Zypper command. We can update individual packages, but we could also update everything all at once if that's what we want to do. But the first thing we'll need to know before we could do that is which updates are actually available. So to list the updates, what I'll do is type Zypper, of course, and then I'll type list hyphen updates, just like that. So I'll press Enter. And as you can see right here, we have three updates available. Now, what we could do is install all of those updates all at once if we wanted to, or we could actually install one update at a time if we'd rather do that. So what I'm going to do first is show you the process for installing an update to a single package. To do that, I'll type sudo and then Zypper, and then I'll type update, and then randomly, I'll just choose the first package on the list as the target for updating. So we'll update that one. And as you can see here, the syntax is fairly simple. We'll first type sudo because we need root privileges, like I mentioned earlier, if we're going to make changes to the system. And we're going over Zypper, so I typed Zypper, just like that. And then after that, I typed the word update because I want to update something. And what I want to update is the package that I typed out right here. So I'll press Enter and let's see what happens. As you can see, it's going to update that one package, just the one that I've selected here. So I'll type Y and then press Enter to confirm the change. And now that package is updated. But you know what? Installing updates to individual packages can be very time consuming if you have a lot of updates. In this case, I only had three that showed up, so it really won't be much of a big problem for me to update the other two manually if I wanted to do that. But you can actually install all the updates all at once, which is actually a great idea. I mean, there's a reason why these updates are made available. Most of the time, there's security updates involved, which is very important. So let's look at the process for updating everything. We'll again type sudo and then Zypper, and then we'll type update. Now, this time, I'm not going to type the name of any package at all. I'm just going to stop right here. I'm going to type sudo Zypper update, and that's it. And because I'm not specifying a specific package, then it's going to update everything. So I'll press enter and let's see what that looks like. Now, there are only two packages that I didn't update with the previous example, so obviously there's not going to be a whole lot to install here, but that's okay. You might have a few updates or quite a few, depending on how long it's been since the last time you've updated your particular installation. In my case, I only have two, so that should be pretty quick. So I'll type Y and then enter. And now it's done. So I've just shown you some examples of installing and updating packages. I also gave you an example of removing a package as well. Now what I'm going to do is show you how to fetch information about a package. Maybe you're not sure whether or not you want to install a package, and you want to find out more information that'll help you decide if that's something that you do want to install. So first we'll type zypper, and then we'll type info. We want to view information about a package. And in this case, I'll use Thunderbird as an example yet again. You could also do the same on your end if you are following along with me. But if you want to view information for a different package, you might need to use the search command first to find out the name of the package. But I already know that the package for Thunderbird is called Mozilla Thunderbird. So let's view some information about it. And here we have some very useful information about the Mozilla Thunderbird package. We can see who the vendor is, for example. In this case, it's suse LLC, which means that this package is maintained by suse, which is great. The architecture is x86, specifically 64-bit x86. If I was to install this package on the system, it would result in 230 megabytes being used, or somewhere around there. The status currently is not installed. That's because I removed it. We have the upstream URL, so we could find out where this particular source code came from. So this is Mozilla Thunderbird, and Mozilla makes Thunderbird available at thunderbird.net. So we can go there to view more information about Thunderbird itself. We have a summary and description section here, and that'll help you understand more about the goal of the package, the goal that it's trying to solve for you. I already know what Thunderbird does. It's an email client. But anyway, as you can see, it's pretty easy to fetch information about a package by simply using zypper info. Now for the next example, what I'm going to do to prepare for the example is I'm going to go ahead and reinstall Mozilla Thunderbird. I'm not going to do anything different this time around compared to the first time that I installed it, but I do need an example package to work with for the next example, so I'll just go ahead and reinstall it. And there it is. Thunderbird is now back on the system. Now the actual example that I want to give you guys right now is how you can go about locking a package. By locking a package, it will not be able to be updated. So for example, if you have a package that needs to be a very specific version, maybe there's bugs in the newer version that you would rather avoid, and you would also rather that package not be updated, and that's especially important if you have automatic updates enabled or something like that. So in that case, you can lock the package to prevent changes. And to do that, we'll run sudo and then zypper, and then next we'll type al. And if you are curious, that stands for add lock. We're going to add a lock to a package. And the package that I'm going to lock is the one that I've just installed. And there's the command. So I'll press enter. And it tells me that the lock has been successfully added. Now, if you want to understand which packages have been locked on your system, there's actually a way that you can pull a list of locked packages. And, well, I'll show you that right now. So for that, I'll type zypper, then ll, which in this case stands for list locks. And actually, that should be it. I'll press enter. And as you can see here, Mozilla Thunderbird has been locked. So that's pretty straightforward. If I've locked other packages, those packages would actually be shown right here. Now, if you want to remove a lock, that's pretty easy to do as well. We want to remove a lock in this case. So what we'll do is type letters RL for remove lock. And then, of course, the name of the package. And it says one lock has been successfully removed. So if I list the locks again, it tells me that no packages are locked, which is exactly what we would expect it to say. And with that example, we've reached the end of this tutorial. Now, sure, there's other things that you could do with the zypper command as well, But I can't go over every single option in one video, but I did go over all the essentials of the Zypper command, which should definitely help you out. If this video did help you out, then please consider clicking that like button to let YouTube know that this video helped you out. And who knows, maybe that'll result in more Linux content on YouTube. I really hope that's the case anyway. But if nothing else, thank you so much for watching. I really appreciate it, and I'll see you again very soon.